Good evening. Political commentator George Will has said that if you want to understand America, you must understand baseball. Frank Farley, one of my guests tonight, says no. If you want to understand America, you must understand extreme sports.
270 to ice pack, slap it in. Abuchika.
Holy crap!
Now let's cover your face
and
hands.
No way, no way.
Come on.
It goes like this. Check it out, it's about a boy who gets his finger caught in a bottle of Mr. Piss. And they go on adventures. I think it could be big. Is it too soon to whisper Oscar? Put a happy ending there and it'll write itself, I swear. All we need are some meetings and a lead. I got an idea for a movie.
Lower down, you guys. Hang in there.
Come on, try to hit me.
Yeah, we'll do this.
No, come on.
Oh, slow yeah. Motion. Yeah.
Be nice.
Here's one. Here's a good one. Ready? Throw a punch for me. Hey, now you're stealing my tricks.
Rolling action. We're out of film on this, Mag. I think we should, I think we should be rapping. So. That's a wrap!
Yeah, I'm actually moving tomorrow. Going out to North Carolina.
Don't marry a North Carolina girl.
Just why are Americans risking life and limb for the big rush? Well, we've assembled a blue ribbon panel to help us find out.
My way to North Carolina, moved out of my hometown where I've lived all my life, Los Gatos, and just decided to move in with my teammate, Dave Mira. He's like the top guy in the sport, the number one rider, like as far as street and vert and pretty much everything else goes.
Your education seemed to only come from TV, I say.
This is my new house here, moving in here, beginning here January, beginning of 99. Okay, what we have here is about an acre and a quarter, and I'm gonna build a nice vert ramp right out the back there, 40 foot wide, 11 foot.
Dirt. moving with Dave is awesome. Man, a lot of fun. Living with Dave, I'll learn a lot of different stuff, like technical stuff.
I call this the reach arm sweep. It's where you get, you know, all the extra suds off the floor. And then you dust it. There you go, thin mop. You can tell, Steve, if you get a little lower, on the floor, you can see the thin layer of water, how it's... Oh, there's a cat, too. He's going to wreck the whole mop job. But yeah, this is when I was 15, Rod and Bert. That's my first picture ever in the magazine. Little tweak no hand there. Some more oldies. Man, we used to ride in our basement in the winter. My dad would be like, I know riding. Oh, here's a picture for you. When I just started riding quarter pipe in 87, so elbow pads on my knees. Helmet was way too big. Here we go. Here's a sixth grade picture right here. Doing a power mower. Comb in the back pocket, you know.
Crazy.
Jumping curbs, jumping garbage cans. I mean, we had so many people in the neighborhood, man, that rode bikes and stuff. It was awesome. And me and my brother, you know, Jim Cook, Ron Smith, my cousin Jamie, we were always into it. Sean Wagner, Gene Wagner, Jim Brown, older guys. Used to crash a lot when you were younger and stuff, but the roots of it was just having fun, really.
First bike I had was like a Kent. I don't know, it was like a little 16-inch bike, you know, jumping curbs, just running through puddles and stuff when I was a kid. And I guess the kind of like I started getting serious about, you know, like started dirt jumping and stuff like that probably around 7 years ago.
Yeah. Toby, I think it was.
Yeah. So okay, we're gonna enter Chittenango. You guys ready? We got Ken Carmen Auto Sales over here. I don't know if you're gonna look at the places when I tell you what they are. You're just gonna watch me?
Yeah.
Come on.
I don't need to look at that.
Yeah, you gotta look at the places. What good is it to see me? Why don't we just go to a hotel and do this? Ames is where I got a Huffy Pro Lightning on layaway. One of the, you know, first, you know, like high-end bikes back when you're younger. So I got that. So I got that going for me anyway. Just, you know, the neighbor, this is a neighborhood, man. Pretty sick. This is the house right here. I grew up in right here on your right. But it was blue and I had shakes and it was totally different. They took down everything, the bush, everything. How you doing, Miss Drescher?
Hello, how are you?
Good, good.
Good. You know, everybody watches you on TV.
This is the road where I used to pick him up all the time. See this gray hair? It's from him.
Yeah, the runway is like sprint from the parking lot, bunny up the curb, go through a fence that you barely fit through, swerve to the left, and then jump off the jump, and then as soon as you land, grab the brakes, start sliding and slam into some hay bales. It wasn't the best setup, but it worked.
You ready, ladies and gentlemen?
it's almost getting to where it's like 10% physical and then 90% mental, and my mentality is like at 50% right now. You know, I just reliving the thing in my head, like today, just thinking about, man, why'd I have to over-rotate that flip, or, you know, why'd I have to miss my bars and loop out, or just, you know, just boom, just think.
Let's take this opportunity now to add Dave Mira into the program. Dave, you're the top-ranked BMX freestyler in the world. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
If I'm seeing these videos right, you must be 20 or 30 feet up in the air doing flips on your bicycle.
Well, the ramps are usually about 11, 12 feet tall.
Uh-huh.
You go about 11 or 12 above those. You're about 20 to 25 feet in the air.
Now, I heard you say on the air that, heck, who needs their spleen anyway? Maybe we don't need our spleens, but I bet some listeners think they do.
Andre, you want to try flip?
I don't know too much about Andre. You know, I'm teammates with him, but I've only met him a few times. But, man, just some of the stuff I've heard he's done at 13 years old is insane. That kid's going to be around, so watch out for him. He's gonna be the next Nyquist coming up, you know?
You got, just pull, push your feet, pull, look. Go, go, go!
It's gonna take you a lot of work, but it'll be good. Don't jump like this, just boom, throw your legs above your head and keep your head right around, keep centered on the bike and...
Pull,
yeah!
Pull,
pull,
pull.
Yeah!
Pull!
Yeah, yeah! As you feel, you just got to keep following the same tranny all the way around. Don't try to jump straight and then torque it. Just try
to... When you start getting upside down, start pulling the bars, like, into your lap.
This time he'll come around, he'll learn it, he'll be, like, doing them for fun now.
Come on, Andre, pull
come
around.
Come on, Andre.
Lean back.
Adrian! Yeah!
Adrian!
Watching her at the mall, she don't know me.
So what do you think so far? Nice, huh? Coming up here on the left is Sun Chevrolet. I worked here for 2.5 days. I was washing cars. This is just before I got sponsored by Haro Bikes. This guy's telling me how to wash cars, and I couldn't handle it, so I went to lunch on the third day and never went back. That was my last job, actually, that I've had. So here, this corner right here is where I got hit by my first car. When I was younger. Cops canteen right here. We're gonna pull in because this is my first job ever, and I think I ended up getting let go, fired, whatever you want to call it, because I was I couldn't do it, you know what I mean? But this is I used to do dishes. Right in those two windows right there, you might even see a dishwasher popping his head out. That's where I worked for my first job. I was 15, got back from a summer tour, and they said, we're not gonna hire you back because I was a wise guy.
So far, there's no doubt, things are working out. Between us, we can't cover every base. You're cute, I'm not, I'm sharp. You've got a certain way of spilling all over the place. But you just keep me warm. Tell them to let me back in. Look nice and they won't think twice about it, baby, because there's no stopping us. With my brains, your looks, your fate, my looks, we could catch a thousand gravy trains. It would be bad if all we had was my looks and your brains. So hold my hand.
This is my middle school. The bike rack's over here. There's like a little bump where you could just kind of launch out, and after school that was like, you know, like show off, you know, your skills and stuff. Right over here, just kind of hop off that little lip where the cement starts through that gate, and then just kind of flying, you know, do a little kick out or whatever. Girls loved it. That's the cafeteria right back there. Used to eat all my crappy food and stuff. Hey, that's my dad.
I got that one.
I hope so.
Boosh. Boosh.
Yeah.
Do it again.
This rules.
Yeah.
Damn.
That's nice. That is nice.
Truck.
That was nice.
Now, Professor Farley, some say that extreme sportsmen and women have a death wish.
Absolutely no death wish. That's an old Freudian idea that should have died a long time ago. To the contrary, they have a wish to live, a desire to live. The reason they take the precautions is so they don't kill themselves, so they'll have another exciting day.
Been a long weekend already. Just started.
I feel like I want to go home. I just don't feel like riding the street this weekend. I just want to go home and watch movies.
What kind of movies?
Like Titanic.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
A nice romantic comedy. You know, something I could just chill to.
You think that's funny when a ship sinks, man?
Action figure. Basically, we're gonna be action figures. I don't know, like, kids are gonna pick it up and, like, actually think, like, should I get Hulk Hogan? Should I get Ryan Nyquist? Like, Mom, what do I get? Can I get both?
With big feet and straight teeth, it's hard to impress a guy like your dad. When I went to school in September, you were all I had.
Nyquist giveaway. When's Ryan's Haro? When's Ryan's... Wow, this is cool. Can I open this one?
Yeah, go for it.
This is gonna rule. Yeah, so these are all mine for me?
Yes. Kids love ya.
All that?
So okay, what's this contest?
A couple for Rider of the Year, Racer of the Year. This is Ryan's bike.
I like Ryan Nyquist because he can ride anything. Dirt, vert, street, trails. He does it all. It won't be long before he beats Mira in the X Games. Horror rules, NorCal rules. Give the bike to this kid. I think he's...
Okay, this is the cemetery jump in Chittenango. This is where all of us rode so many hours practicing, learning 360s, doing nothings off this thing to flat ground. It was back when this was all you had. But they put up these posts for a reason, because they didn't want us jumping here anymore, and they thought a chain across here would stop us, but we just started jumping over it, and it was the best thing. But if you look at these posts, I used to abubica these posts.
What's an abubica?
It's when you go up and land on your back wheel and hop back in, fakie. So it's everybody will know what it is when they see this. If they ride bikes, if not, then you know, the guessing game. Mysterious things. The contest in 1992 and 93, when it was, the sport was considered dead, it would be me, Matt, and Dennis, $200 for first place, but it would be so gnarly, and just we'd go for so much stuff, and it was insane. It was a lot of fun when you look back to it. Pretty much gave up everything in life for bike riding. You know, I didn't ever look into a full-time job with full employee benefits. I rode a bike. I made a couple $1,000 a year because I went and did fair shows. I mean, that was just surviving then, and now it's, I definitely feel like I've paid my dues. I've lost my spleen. I broke my shoulder. I've been slammed on the ground. I've been, I've got back up and kept doing what I love. I mean, that just right there shows that you love something.
Envision in your mind a continuum of human behavior. At one end you have what I call big T behavior. That's thrill seeking, that's where the T comes from, risk taking, excitement seeking, stimulation seeking. At the other end of the continuum you have small T behavior, and I use the small letter T. People at that end are risk averse. They cling to the tried and the true and the predictable and the rules and the regulations and the laws and the status quo. Most people are neither a big T nor a small T. Most people are in the middle somewhere. And so they can take a risk if they have to, but it's not a way of life.
I told you.
Oh, yeah. It really sounded like a motorcycle.
It came by yesterday at a baseball card in the sports room. Baseball card got all messed up, like it wasn't making noise, so I had a cannon. But you got a different cannon.
Pretty sweet. You sound like a motorcycle. We can hear you all the way down the corner.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Pretty good. Put one on the back, too. Should we try and rig one on the back?
We should.
Is it going to go on there, though?
Sure. Can I try that?
Go for it. It'd be like twice as loud. Your parents will love us.
It really sounds like a motorcycle. Ryan's mostly into soccer, I guess, you know? I get kind of jealous, because he used to always score all the goals. We all did sports, like we did, you know, baseball and soccer. And Ryan would always score goals every game. I never scored one goal in, like, 9 years of soccer.
When he was probably 4 years old is when we started. We put a ramp on the grass. We made a little ramp for him. And they would go down the street, ride up here as fast as they could, and then jump on the little ramp. Ramp was probably about this big. So, nah, about that big. And they would see how high they could get.
I never in a million years dreamed that it would lead to this. I mean, he rode the bike and did all this and the tricks and because he loved doing it. I used to be nervous about it, but hey, you can get hurt doing any sports, and he loved it, so hey, go for it, you know.
My philosophy was on injury-wise is that you control your own kind of destiny with bike riding. It's an individual sport. If you crash, it's because you're probably going for something you want to learn, whatever, you know, accidents happen. But if you're playing football and you got some 240-pound meathead slob running after you and you're like, you blindside your knee and you twist it, then that sucks because that's that guy wanting to hurt you. Like, I want to tackle this guy so bad, so the people are going to look at me and be like, yeah, and the coach is going to come up and spank me or something, you know, and that's not really what we're all about, you know, so it's kind of nice on the injury thing that you bring on your own pain, really. And accidents happen, you know.
I'll try to pull like that so you can come around. But try not taking off like this. Try taking off like that.
This is fun.
Yeah! Dude, that was smooth. Oh!
That was dumb, dude.
Pretty notchy.
Feather in the hat band. Cut loose from the folks. Streamers in the handles. Baseball cards in the spokes. Get the pallet on the skateboard. The belly to the ground. Rush of the tarmac. I'm back in my elementary, safe and sound.
I don't know. Being there is kind of a cool feeling. You know, kind of like a bird, but kind of not, because you got a bike underneath you.
Hanging on a chain link under the barn door. Up from the basement, loose boards, old floor. Hiding in the swamp grass, weeping in the willows. I'm sneaking off to the railway, someday wind up sitting. Calm and still, waiting here, slack and clear on the inside. Born again, every day.
The one thing about extreme sports is they're active. They're very active, very engaging, very creative, very inventive. There's a lot of room for individuality to do things in a particular, unique way. You know, some of the traditional sports, you stand around a lot. You know, if you think about baseball, you're standing a lot. This is a very inventive, creative, risk-taking country. A lot of our traditional sports don't reflect that at all. And I think it's a coming of age in America, frankly, the development of these kinds of sports.
I think our stuff's getting, you know, skateboarding, bike riding's getting so popular because everybody looks happy when they're doing it. You're not getting yelled at by a coach. They know you're doing it because you love to do it, and it looks a lot like it's a lot of fun. And the creativity that all of these athletes have is awesome, and it shows.
All rollerbladers with afternoon instruction, please head up to the playground. All skateboarders to the school, and all bikers with afternoon instruction, head to Lot 8.
Luxurious.
Things are different on my block. I don't know if you heard about how these folks are living, and I can't help you out.
What's going on here? Right now we're just at Woodward. Like my home, I guess, for the moment. But just hanging out here, gonna be here for a while, just training, getting ready for the next contest coming up and stuff. And Woodward Camp is like, it's kind of like a Club Med for me, but like without, you know, all the, you know, stuff. I don't know. I've never been to one, so I don't know what they got, but I heard they're pretty good.
Try to figure out the rules
Okay.
Let me see.
Hi, I'm Dave Mirra. Just straight to the camera. That's all.
Hi, I'm Dave Mirra.
All right, get up.
I'm part of Generation Hope. Voices of Change, only on Wham, I guess. So who else is here doing a PSA?
Cynthia Cooper. She's the MVP for women's basketball, the WNBA.
Terrell Davis.
He's the MVP of the NFL.
Okay.
Tish Venturini.
From the Women's World Cup soccer.
Oh, really? Cool.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
NSYNC.
Ooh.
You're in good company, don't you think?
Yeah, I'm psyched.
I think they're in good company, too.
What did you guys choose me for, really? You know,
You were on the list the kids wanted to hear from.
Oh, really?
You made the list.
Oh, really? That's crazy. That's pretty mainstream.
Yeah.
I think it gets you to look back towards me.
Crazy shot there, man. I don't want to be like doing some like cosmopolitan like turnaround look. Try to keep this, you know, as bike oriented as we can. Right here, man. Here, I'll show you from the experience I've had with PSAs and
scar on the hand.
Thing good is
scar on the hand.
Coming from this angle right here. The lines.
I say, hi, I'm Dave Mirra. I'm honored to be part of Generation Hope, Voices for Change, only on Wham.
Okay.
And then we'd like, hey, Jen Hope, are you taking a stand against violence? You know, hoping somebody else will solve the problem isn't a solution. It's up to you. Watch Wham for more ideas on how you can. The Voices for Change start with compassion and understanding, so stop the violence. And you can put this into your own words. I'm cool with that. Turn your head and say it.
Okay. I'm part of Generation Hope, Voices of Change, only on Wham.
Once again, Voices for Change, only on Wham.
I'm part of Generation Hope, Voices of Change.
Voices for Change.
Voices for Change. Okay, let's see. How are we doing? I'm going to start like this and go there?
Yeah.
Okay, give me that line again.
Look down like where you were looking at the camera before.
Okay.
And I'm part of Generation Hope, Voices for Change, only on Wham.
I'm part of Generation Hope, Voices for Change, only on Wham.
Golden
shower. Right.
Golden. Okay, here we go.
Okay, right. Let's make this happen.
This is a great look. You look very handsome.
Thank you.
I'm ready whenever you are.
Okay, let's hit it.
Okay, go.
Generation Hope, Voices for Change. Find your dream and follow it.
You can find other people who are doing the same thing mentally. Albert Einstein, he spent his whole life on the edge of uncertainty.
But you say Albert Einstein was a type T.
Absolutely.
Einstein never wore inline skates, but he was a risk taker.
A lot of the people around him were really sort of experimenting with drugs and alcohol. It was like, no. And in turn, Ryan used to get high on Skittles. It sounds cliche, but he would show up at a party with like a 2 liter of Coke and like a bag of Skittles and just sit there and laugh. I mean, his laugh is intoxicating. Nonetheless, winter, we would have these parties. And they were called the Ramp Club Christmas Party. We were at one of these Christmas parties, and I have this photograph of Ryan learning nose picks on the quarter pipe, and there are two of my friends, and they're sitting up on the top of the quarter pipe with beers in their hand, and they're just laughing at Ryan. But it's almost like, who's laughing now?
like 101 and do a big 540 on the corner and just on the mountain. I wanted to do a Washington flip and just stuff on the spot and just kind of, you know, whatever came up, I did it. So.
You saw a kid with some green tough wheels and you had blue. You were like, dude, those look so dope, man. Where you live? Oh, you want to ride? You'd keep in touch with people and you'd go ride with them. And it was just insane. It was just, it was the best, man. You know, I've met some awesome people through bike riding.
Like street and stuff, like they've been playing it up. Like me and Dave are huge rivals and stuff, and we hate each other. Like, you know, like, will friendship get in the way of blah blah blah? And I'm like, you know, they always got to find something to stir up some controversy and make it interesting. But it's like, I don't know. I was stoked last night when Dave won. Like, you know, because I mean, honestly, in Bert, I can't even come close to what level he is. So all I can do is just really cheer him on, and I was stoked when I saw it, you know.
So big, leave the light on, have you gone? Leave the pictures in their itching frames where they belong. Leave the bed sheets unclean, and they will pick up your spill. Cover me in resolve. So please leave the imagery. It's gonna be crazy, but the game's gonna be sick. I mean, it's gonna be somewhat realistic, but also on the other hand, it's gonna be fantasy moves to act like you're playing or riding like one of us.
It's gonna be bar spin B, take one.
They made 3D models of me and Dave, and they have corresponding parts on the models to where these balls are on our bodies.
Negative X 146.
So when we do a trick, the sensors track all these things, you know, all the cameras and stuff, and they make it a 3D image.
Hey, can you zip me up?
This is kind of like something I used to wear.
That's it. Really? Where is this? Oh, yeah.
Back in my prime. Oh, got panty lines on. Take that off.
Three Extreme. I don't know who made that. I don't want to offend anybody, but that game was, you know, I'd rather go out and dig a hole in my backyard than play that game.
That's pretty cool.
How long this stuff takes. Kind of gets a little frustrating, you know?
Mm. It's weird, like, how much, like, stuff you really need for, like, sound. Like, mm-hmm. Bar spins. You know, I had to sit there and spin the bars a bunch of times, riding on grass.
tail taps, you need to go up and do a tail tap. Grinds. And skidding.
Attention, and you have to pay attention to them early because this type T thing starts unfolding fast. The best thing you can do is channel him, guide him in healthy forms of risk taking and thrill seeking. Some people think they'll stamp it out with laws and rules and say, you will not do this. You can't stamp it out. Kids react, the T types react negatively toward that. You don't want bowling, and I would abandon any thought of baseball.
Who knows what he would do with the bowling ball?
You want to stay here and film, Rob? You want to come up a little closer? I'm going to foo-foo right in between you guys.
You're going to what?
I'm going to foo-foo this railing right in between you guys.
Come on. Is it going to break off?
Like if you stand there and you guys are just hanging out talking, yeah. I'm just going to come up here and grab
okay.
between
all right,
you.
Nice. I don't know what's going on here. Oh, he did. That's the first time I've ever seen something like that.
So wait, do you live here too, Ryan?
Yeah, I moved here in March. Used to live with Dave, but I got my own house now, so.
Really?
Yeah. This town's pretty sick. It's awesome.
Yeah, yeah,
Ryan.
Dude,
that
was the best one I've ever done yet.
You know what? We weren't here really to do anything on Nyquist, but we're probably gonna have to go to his house and get into his cotton field. You guys know how I like cotton from this morning, don't you?
You know, the touch and feel of cotton, it's like the fabric of our lives.
Can we get cotton as a sponsor?
That was crazy. I didn't think about throwing double till I was already in the air. This mini's
all about the air. Whoa. Whoa.
Oh,
man, I got gutted.
You try to see? That's a party.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, my God.
Yeah! Yeah.
What?
Pretty far. Just looking at the ramp now, it's like, how high and far did I go? But at least I cleared them. Thank God I didn't land on anybody.
You do a lot of jumping?
Yeah.
What kind of stuff do you jump at home?
People.
What's your record on people?
You can do 10 people.
on the ramp. I'm always the last guy in line in case he doesn't clear it, but he's never hit me. I just never look up. I keep my eyes shut till I hear the back tire slap on the pavement. But he's into it. He's got a nice quarter pipe at home that he rides, him and his sister. And, of course, it's the neighborhood get-together. There's 10, 15 kids a day at the house. And he's the ringleader. I'm lucky. I'm blessed to have two good kids. And if maybe this could keep him from having to work a 9-to-5 like the rest of us, you know, like Dave and Ryan. I mean, they're living a dream, and it should be every kid's dream to do what they do.
Think about Dave and Ryan.
I think they're awesome. Didn't miss 1 minute of their X Games. Sat in that lounge chair for the whole 200 hours or so. It was great.
You know Ryan Nyquist likes Skittles.
He does?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, I got it. Only time. of the life. But that's right, man, you got.